Hey there, folks. Welcome once again to PIVX class. Today I'm going to try and explain how the Zerocoin protocol gives coins like PIVX and Zcoin their anonymity. Last week we covered zero knowledge proofs, and it would be very helpful for you to watch that first. If you don't know what zero knowledge proofs are, just pause this video, click this card link above, and go check that out. It'll help you out a lot. Anyways, providing you have that preliminary information, we can come to understand Zerocoin transactions in a quick and easy manner. So without further ado, let's get started. We'll keep this simple by breaking this down into three sections: making a Zerocoin, spending a Zerocoin, and what happens after. It is important to keep in mind that not all cryptocurrencies that use Zerocoin are the same. There are some key differences between each. Furthermore, there are other protocols that do things different entirely. Zerocash, used by Zcash, is frequently confused with Zerocoin, but it is not the same. We'll be covering Zerocoin in a simple way, so it should fit most implementations, but some might still diverge a little from this explanation. Anyways, all that aside, how do you make a Zerocoin? Well, Zerocoin cryptocurrencies have normal coins like PIV, the coin of PIVX. This would be their normal everyday coin. When someone wants to make a normal coin into anonymous Zerocoin, they must mint it. In PIVX's case again, this would be called the ZPIV. You are given a number of denomination options. This means you have to mint Zerocoin in denominations like 1, 5, 10, 20, 50, and so on. To do this, you essentially spend normal coins. It'd be like putting your money in a big magic box. The magic box gives you a one-time use key, a Zerocoin, that only you have the ability to use. This is where zero knowledge proofs come in. So again, look above if you don't know what I'm talking about with that. That key, that Zerocoin, is your zero knowledge proof. The Zerocoin proves your contribution and that you are owed for the normal coins you put in. This Zerocoin doesn't specify which coins were yours though, just how many you put in. And that's how you get a Zerocoin. There's nothing more to it, really. So what happens when you receive a Zerocoin? Well, the first thing is that you don't. The person who holds Zerocoin spends it, but the person receiving it will just get its value in normal coins. Let's say I owe Ben 8 coins. I have a 10 normal coin valued Zerocoin. I take it to the magic box, punch in Ben's receive address, cash the Zerocoin, and the box will create brand new normal coins to send to Ben. That's right. The magic box doesn't even use any old normal coins with transaction histories. It creates brand new ones. See, coins go in, but only their value is kept. The individual identity of each coin is gone. Not that crazy, really. It just breaks down one coin to make it new again. It's like melting down a real gold coin and reminting it with a new serial number. So back to Ben. The box sends Ben 8 brand new normal coins. Ben is happy because you paid him. But wait, you cashed a 10-coin Zerocoin to pay back Ben 8 coins. What happens to your other 2 coins? Well, that brings us to what happens after. This isn't much crazier, really. We call this change, like the change you get back from a cashier when you buy something. The first option for what to do with this change is to simply send the remaining 2 coins back to your wallet. This can be an anonymity weak spot, though. Someone may be able to figure out your transactions as a result of your change. Option 2 would be to mint your change into smaller Zerocoins to make them anonymous once again. If the change is too small for any Zerocoin denomination though, the remainder can be thrown into the fees so that it doesn't come back to you. This does result in you losing that remainder though. And these are 2 of the solutions for that change. It is important to note that this last part is likely the most flexible between cryptocurrencies. Different currencies may handle this differently. So it's best to check how the specific currency handles their change before making transactions. And that's it. I know, right? Not actually that crazy. If I were to summarize it into a couple lines here, put money in a box and get a voucher for some brand new money. Cash that voucher in for brand new money to be sent where you choose, and then the change kind of pings back to you. And that's it. Zerocoin has been a tough and confusing topic for many, so I hope this sheds some light on it. Being that my explanation might be too simple for some and not explained enough, please feel free to comment below and I will answer your questions as much as I can. Thank you for tuning in, guys. As always, I love having you here, and I will see you in the next PIVX class.